Hello, hello, everybody. It's Friday again, and it means it's time for us to do some art together. You want to say hello?
Hi.
Yeah. So now people will slowly start joining, and we're going to wait for them. And
also, if you would like to...
It's a bit early, because we only have got at the moment 3 people, so we need to wait for other people to join in. Yeah? So, we're going to ask... for people to say hello in the comments, so we know who's watching. And if you could say hello from and child's name, we'll try to say hello back as we spot. Also, if you never joined our lives before, it's really helpful when we tell you to put thumbs up, because if you understood something or child has said something which you know, you heard from Melina or from me, that just helps us to keep it a bit more engaging for children as well. So we are going to begin at 3 o'clock exactly. So at the moment we're just going giving chance for people to join and say hello. You want to say something? You can't do that because we are in life.
Yeah, I know, but I want to tell you something. So you just ask you if it. If you want to say it to everyone, in case they came in a bit late.
Just say it, and I'll correct it. No, it's alright, just say it. Oh no, it's fine. Yeah. Okay, so we got 8 people watching. 9, hello everybody. Melina, do you want to give children a first task?
Oh yes, so the first task will be is to pick a fruit, a vegetable or a flower.
So yes, if you could go and find in your house an object, preferably a piece of fruit or a flower. You can bring also vegetable, it can be also a book, so just one object. And in the meantime, I have prepared for Melina to choose one of the fruits here. So while the children are going to get a fruit, Melina is going to pick one and then we'll put the rest away. And once your children are back with their object, you know, with their fruit or flower or something else, could you put thumbs up? So I know some people here already done the very, very small first task. So each one you're going to pick.
Meanwhile, I'll be picking.
Decisions. So what you got here?
So I've got a kiwi.
Yeah. Pomegranate.
Orange. 2 apples.
Okay.
And a lemon.
Right, now choose one.
Which one? I don't know.
You got to be quicker. Just make decisions. Your life does not depend on it. Okay, I'm going to count backwards from 5. And you got to choose. Oh, well done. Okay, so...
I picked a lemon.
You picked a lemon. So I hope some children are back already. But we are going to begin. Actually, Melina, you put it down. And you haven't even... looked at it. So the thing is, today we are studying still life. So it's images of sometimes it's called natura morta, so life which doesn't move, or like a dead life. But it's actually sometimes it could be birds or insects which, you know, not necessarily no longer alive. So because it's still life, getting a fruit and really looking at it is one of the first things we are going to do, because
would be useful to start looking at it now, so you will notice more details.
Exactly. So how does your lemon look like? Is it completely the same color?
No. So some of it is more like yellow.
Mm-hmm.
And some of it is more like orange, darker yellow with some brown on it. And also the detail I saw was, if you're going to ask, and also you can look for patterns on yours if they have any patterns.
Mm-hmm.
I see a pattern here, dots everywhere, my lemon.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like a nice pattern when you roll it.
Yeah, and is it completely round or has slightly different shape?
It's Not completely round, like an apple.
Does it have any shine on it?
Like if you put it in the sunlight, it shines.
Okay, so from the sun you can see that actually sun is reflecting on the fruit. Okay, great. So we can put it away. And if you looked at your fruit or your object very closely, you probably also would notice a lot more than when it just would be in the same basket with all the other fruits or in the fridge before. Even if you are about to eat it, sometimes we don't look at those things. So for those people who never joined us before, please now bring up on your screens a first image, which is a basket of fruit by Caravaggio. So that the children can look at it at the same time as Melina will start looking at the image. And then later on we will need a second image, which I have been posted in the group before. And that will be Sunflowers by Van Gogh. So Melina, we are doing the first thing as usual, visual analysis.
Yeah, and also I don't see anyone typing up yet. That's fine.
Yeah, maybe there is delay, maybe people just would like to watch today. So, but it's a good point. For those who haven't joined us in two previous sessions, if your child says something, just type it up in the comment, helps them out, and then we will know what observations they made. But it's okay not to do. Melina, please start with visual analysis. So, reminder again, at the moment Melina is looking at Basket of Fruit by Caravaggio, which was painted around 1599. To be honest, art historians give different dates, but it's like a circle.
For more like 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
No, this one will be just a minute. And then you will start describing it. But for now, just look at it quite closely. And children as well, please look at the image. So first of all, you know, virtually just analyze what can you see, you know, what objects can you see, what light is like, what colors are like, what is happening around the main composition. So as many details and as you can notice will help you with understanding artwork better. And the reason why, while Melina is analyzing that, and the reason why we're talking about still life, it's quite often you go into museums and you see those things on the wall and, you know, you spend like 10 seconds and you walk past, not really understanding why such images would be in museums at all. So a purpose of choosing different themes is to give you opportunity to understand those artworks better. So what do you think, Melina? Have you had an opportunity to have a good look?
Yes, so what I see, I see a bowl, a basket full of fruit with grapes, different colored grapes, apples, lemons, loads of leaves, and it's quite bright colors, not really dark, dull colors.
And do they look like real fruit, or do they look really painted? You know, you like
they look you like me would real, paint. Real fruit. Like I could just reach in and grab and eat it. Mm-hmm. They look really real.
They look really real. So.
So what I thought think is that they just used a thin paintbrush to make them look really real. I can even see the detail on the lemon. Mm-hmm. Really detailed.
That's pear, but yes. Mm-hmm. So what about apple? Can you see anything on an apple? Is it in what condition is it? Is it in perfect condition?
It's not really.
Does it have any marks on it?
In
the apple here.
Oh yeah. Yeah, it looks like there's a little black bit.
Mm-hmm. And what about leaves? Can you describe leaves a little bit?
So the leaves are more like darker colors, but not too dark.
And are they perfect, like just on a tree, the new ones? Or do they look a little bit weathered? A little bit like, you know, dying out?
Well, some of them, like over on the left hand side more.
It's the right hand side.
Right hand mm-hmm. side, I mean. Are like dying, crumbling.
Mm-hmm.
And on the right hand, left and right, they're both kind of dying. But at the top, they're not really dying yet.
So
but
kind
they're
of
still dying.
In different condition. And the last question about actual what can visual analysis. What about the background?
The background's quite bright, like it's a sunny day.
But is there anything on it or is it plain?
It's more like plain with more different colors. It looks like a real wall.
Mm-hmm. It looks like a real wall.
Real old room.
Okay. Well done. So, this still life, quite often, there is also, apart from what actually can we see, condition of the fruit and, in what is in the background, what else can is displayed there, like in this case, a basket, there is actually quite often hidden meaning. So, for example, an apple, it's a symbol which symbolizes Eve, so the very first woman mentioned in Bible, Eve's fall from the grace. So that's why it has got that little mark on it, like it's been eaten by worm and is no longer perfect. Vine leaves, they actually, they used to represent Christ. So his divinity and his sacrifice for us. So you can see there that the actually leaves are curling up. And these grapes, they also have got a hidden meaning in Eucharist, in a Catholic Church especially. There is a ceremony where the body of the Christ and the blood of the Christ is accepted. And the grapes represent that sacrifice by Christ as well. So apart from what we actually can see, there is a hidden meaning. But why this painting was chosen to talk about still life? Well, believe it or not, still life was not a topic or was not something what was painted before Caravaggio's work. So he was the first one who actually, instead of just placing vegetables and fruit and nature in images, do you remember like last week we did the image of Christ, there are sometimes images of Christ eating meal with his apostles and fruit would be showing there. Caravaggio was the first one who actually dedicated the whole painting to the still life. So that's why he is considered to be revolutionary. He didn't do many of them. There is possibly another one which is attributed to Caravaggio. He was much more interested later on in painting people. But nevertheless, he has created a whole new genre. Before Caravaggio, you know, Melina, what was happening actually?
What?
There were other people who were painting still life. But it was so, so long ago that Romans did it, ancient Romans. And nobody in Europe knew about it because they all the images got, destroyed or they just no longer existed where could be seen. And we only found out that still life was painted early on in art after Pompeii was excavated. But you know what it is art? One person does it and then another person takes it on and does it as well and does it a bit differently.
Yeah.
Same thing happened to still life as well. It went to from Italy. The actual topic, the actual genre went to Netherlands. So from Netherlands, artists came to Italy to learn about how to paint and they came back to Netherlands at a time where they went through something called Reformation. You know how, Melina, in art there are lots of images of Christ and Mary?
Yeah.
Lots. So Reformation was when in Northern Europe, all of these images were taken from churches and houses and they're getting destroyed. So all the churches suddenly were having those plain walls and then houses were less popular. So then artists from Netherlands went to Italy, saw this work, came back, saw all the empty walls, and they thought, we no longer paint Christian images, we no longer paint Christ, we no longer paint Mary. I'm going to paint fruit and vegetables and other food, you know, and all the bread. So in Netherlands, this style, this genre was very popular. Also society was quite rich. So lots of people were buying artworks. Even bakers could afford it. So it wasn't very expensive. In a way, it was like pop art. You remember Andy Warhol?
Yeah.
When he just produced things. Do you remember? Yeah. So it was similar. The Netherlands artists just started painting lots of landscapes and everybody was buying them. So, this is what happened. And just one thing, I have a question for you. Do you think when you paint something in art, right? Let's say you paint portrait or you paint still life, like fruit and vegetables. Which one is better painting?
So, this one or...
Or portrait.
Or portrait. I actually think the fruit.
And you think opposite of what people used to think. Up to 18th century, there was a hierarchy, meaning levels of how artworks were graded. So still life was the lowest, the least kind of respected form of art. People who used to do still life were considered to be people who just use their skills. They don't really put their heart or a lot of intellectuals or thinking about the topic. They virtually just look at the object very closely and paint it very skillfully. We no longer think like that. It's went away, but just so you remember that this is something what people used to think.
How do you know that?
How do I know that? Because I studied art history, and there are some documents which say that. Yeah, there are some books which...
Yeah, but how did people discover that?
How did they decide on, you mean decide on how to grade them? Well, one person said it and then the rest repeated. You know, this is how everything else used to work.
Yeah, I mean, like, how did people in nowadays find out about they bought that?
Because it was written down in the documents. Yeah. All right. So great. So now let's go to next image. And Melina, you might know who is it by. Do you want to tell everybody?
Yeah, it's from by Vincent van Gogh. And also, if you notice, her company is called Vincent and Frida.
Yeah, and Vincent is for Vincent van Gogh. And Frida?
Frida for Frida Kahlo.
Right, so if you have the second image in front of your children now, that would be great. Could you please look at it? Do it later. You must be quite familiar with the image.
Yeah.
You seen it before?
Yeah.
Do you want to move closer to me? This laptop?
Okay.
You think ready?
Yeah.
Okay, because you're quite familiar with it. Okay, so what can you see?
So what I can see is I see the sunflowers are kind of dying, and the ones that are puffy brown, actually sunflowers beginning to grow.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that what's clever that Vincent did, he wrote his name on the vase.
Mm.
It's more like 3D there. Mm. Vincent.
Yeah. All right. So quite good observation. So I'll ask you a couple of questions then. Tell me a bit about colors. What is the main color there?
The main color is more like yellowy, browny, brown.
Yellow and some brown.
Yeah, yeah.
But the main color is what? The background, if you look at the...
Main color is yellow.
Main color is yellow. Okay. And then another question for children as well to consider. Have a look at the flowers and try to find two flowers which are exactly the same.
Should I do it as well? Okay. Do I have to be grown?
They just have to look exactly the same.
Oh, so they don't have to be the grown ones. Okay. Do they have to look exactly?
Yeah. Are they exactly the same?
I can't tell. Do you know which one?
Well, it might be a tricky question.
But do you know? Do you know?
Alright, so have you managed to find
that one? No.
Well, it's amazing you have managed. Can you move towards me, please? It's amazing you can manage to find exactly the same, because actually there are no two exactly the same flowers. They're all different. Okay. Do you know that this is actually the most
popular,
famous painting by Vincent van Gogh? It's so famous, and a lot of people, when they think Vincent van Gogh, it probably will be one of the first things they're gonna think, sunflowers. And he himself has said that sunflower is mine. He actually has written that to his brother, because he knew the impact of his artworks were going to have in generation. Of course, he didn't know for sure he's going to become popular, but he was so confident that the way he painted sunflowers is so different to everything else before, that if people get chance to look at his artworks, they will forever remember those sunflowers. Do you know the story behind creation of sunflowers?
No.
Do you want to find out?
Yeah.
Okay. So
I'm guessing it's about sun.
It is a lot about sun, actually. So Vincent van Gogh went to a yellow house, which is outside of Paris in the countryside, in a very, very sunny place. And he invited his friend Gauguin to come and join him so they could paint together. And before Gauguin arrived, Vincent decided to paint quite a few of these paintings. So actually, that's not the only one. The one you see at the moment is in National Gallery in London, but they are in the world altogether. There were seven, and there are now five of them left.
What happened to the...
One was in a war. Five, I mean, in museums, we can see. One was destroyed in the World War II. And one is in a private collection, and it hasn't been seen for many, many, many years. So you can go and see five of them. So Gauguin arrived, saw those sunflower images, and he loved them. He genuinely recognized that they were very special, because they had movement. It was only, in some cases, it was mostly yellow. That sunflowers are also having the meaning of the happiness, but, you know, going back to tradition of having double meaning, some of them are dying. So it's a bit like people. They have got a bit quality of a portrait, because they're all different and they seem alive. It's almost like they have got a personality or character. And then, you know what happened afterwards? They actually had a huge, huge argument, Vincent and Gauguin.
About what?
Well, I don't know. Let's say about art, how to paint it. And then Gauguin left. He just got so angry. He left the yellow house where he was living with Van Gogh. And Van Gogh got so desperate, it's when he actually cut off a bit of his ear, and he got so sick that he went into the hospital. So part of this kind of like story, a mystery...
So did he manage to finish the paintings just before he died?
Oh, he finished them very quickly. He painted those very quickly. And he didn't die from cutting off a bit of his ear. So part of the mystery surrounding this painting is that story about Gauguin and Van Gogh getting into argument. That's why it's one of the things which will also make it extra interesting for some people. And you know what happened after that?
What?
About a year later, Gauguin actually written to Van Gogh, and he said to him, you know, even though we had this terrible argument, I really loved those sunflowers. I think they're very special. Could you paint one for me?
Also, he painted them one for him, but then his got broken, maybe.
I don't know which one. I'll need to check which out of seven he actually painted for Goga to give it to him. I'll have to double check that. Okay, so, and the signature. One thing you have mentioned that we can see. So he was so proud of his work, and he knew that it was so special. And actually, it's kind of representing not only sunflowers, but the personality of Van Gogh as well. You know how he did the thick paints and very expressive.
Yeah.
By the way, if you want to see textures, the best place to see this image is actually on the National Gallery website. So just go there, type up sunflowers Van Gogh, and you will be able to really, really make the image bigger, and you will see the brush strokes. Not
well.
At the moment, you do it later. So so it's kind of like, you know, when you see them, you'll know that it's by Van Gogh because of all the paints and all the brush strokes, and it's very, you won't forget that, right? It's so memorable, this image. You can still see the paint. One more thing before we finish up. So we're still live. There are some other meanings we wanted to mention. So in vanitas, it's type of images. There are other things sometimes included. Melina, you want to show this one? What is that?
A skull?
Skull. So what do you think that could represent, mean in a...
All I know that it was in the crucifixion.
Yeah, what was it in crucifixion?
Well, the death, the sign of death.
Exactly. So it's a reminder of that we are mortals, that we are dead. Then you quite often would see these two things. I mean, of course, not modern. You know, it's the only one I could find. But the watch and...
Time.
The hourglass. So
glass.
As you can see, the time is just flying away. Again, you know, that would mean in a still life that we only have limited amount of time in this earth, so we have to remember that. Also, you'll see the candle. That is to remind people that life is burning away. So it's all kind of making you think about the meaning of life. And sometimes you'll see book as well. And book is more about you are writing your story. So while all of these things, showing you that, you know, life is short, but you can make an impact, you can create a story, and you can write your own book. So, Melina also, yes. So, if you feel inspired, you can go and try to make your own copy. Melina, you want to show yours?
So, this is my copy I did?
Yeah. So, Melina, with help of her art teacher, Valentina, I don't know if she's watching Valentina Rainey, a year ago or so, maybe 2 years ago, has also tried to paint a copy of... sunflowers. So yes, I hope you enjoyed the lesson, everybody. So next time you go to museums, please remember still life was not always the topic of the images. You know, it's only became popular because of Dutch people really wanted to make art accessible and put it everywhere into every single house. Please remember that sometimes there is a double meaning in the objects displayed there. Pay attention to how it's executed. It's because it will make you think about everyday objects. You know how we at the beginning just looked at a lemon, which we normally would not notice. It's the same with still life. You know, it just makes you stop and kind of be mindful of what you are seeing. Everyday objects become the focus of your attention.
And one thing, just because you picked one fruit or one vegetable doesn't mean you can't look at all the others with their detail.
Very good observation. It's definitely worth slowing down sometimes and spending a bit more time looking at the texture of things and making your own observations. And of course, once galleries are open, please go and see Vincent van Gogh sunflowers. Have a look at it. You know, see if it's actually, if you like it, first of all, and also if you notice how yellow it is and how life and expressive it is, and look at the paint, because there will be a lot of thick brush strokes and a quite thick paint.
That was more like Van Gogh's, than like the Van Gogh style he would paint in.
Yeah. So thank you so much for joining us, for watching us. Next week, same time, Friday, 3 p.m., we are going to do landscape. So another thing which you quite often will see in museums is landscape. So let's find out a bit more about them and have a great weekend.
Bye.
Bye.